Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel Computer Science Classes by Nikhil Srivastava. And in this video we will continue our discussion of group by clause. So what we studied in the previous video, we saw that group by clause is used to group together rows, and then you know group functions are applied on those grouped rows. So this we already saw in the previous video. Now let us continue our discussion after this. So if you just have a look at the second point, group functions are executed after the where clause. So what does this line means? Okay, so you can always, you know, keep this thing as a, you know, it, you can keep it as a rule that you can always remember that group functions will always be executed once the where clause has finished its execution. Okay, so let us try to practically understand it. So this is my database, and you know, I'll just, you know, although I've selected, but still again, you know, this is my employees table. Okay, now this, you know, what we have already seen till now is that suppose I want you to find the count of all employees per department. Okay, for example, how many employees in department number 10, how many in department number 20, and how many in department number 30. So this query is very simple. We have already seen this query, comma, suppose so I want you know, from which table? From the employees table, and group by department ID. If I write like this, I will get, you know, department number 10, 20 and 30. And what exactly is happening over here, if I, you know, just I revise your concept for just your revision, and I'll just draw it so that, you know, things are clear. So what exactly is happening is that, you know, it is grouping together rows. So, you know, this for example, this department number 10 is forming one group. This department number 20, you know, it is forming one more group. You know, these all rows will come under department number 20. These rows will come under department number 20. This group will belong to department number 20. This group will also belong to department number 20, and this group will also belong to which department? Department number 20. And once, you know, these groups have been formed, the group functions will be applied. And what is the group function we have used over here? We have used a count function, so it will count the number of rows. Okay. So this way it is working, it looks out to be fine, but I have some more requirement, and I want to omit out the department number 30, and I only want the count of employees working either in department number 10 or in department number what, or in department number 20. So what query will you write? What will you do to solve this query? Give it a try. I'll pause, I'll wait. I think it is very simple. So what I'm going to do, select department ID, comma, count of what? Let us first of all, you know, write select star from, you know, so that every, and let me order it by suppose department ID. First of all, let us do this, then write our query. So what query will I write? I will write, because I want to group by department ID, I will select department ID, and then I will write select what? Select count star from the table. My name of my table is the employees table, and I will write group by department ID. If I write like this, sorry, I only want for department number 10 and 20. So what will I write? I will use a where clause, where department ID in, and what it should be in, either in department number 10 or in department number what, 20, and then I have to group by what? Group by department ID. Okay, so now if you just see, if I take the pen tool, you know, I'll just take this pen tool, and you know, this query is almost, you know, same to this query. Okay, what we have done over here is almost same what we did over here, but here, you know, we have omitted this. What we have omitted? We have omitted department number 30. How we have omitted department number 30? Because we have used the group, because we have used the where clause. Okay, where clause we have used. And if you are able to understand it, what I have written over here, suppose here what I've written, group functions are executed after the where clause. So what does this mean? This means that first this select will run in, you know, in conjunction of where, and first the rows will be filtered, and then once the rows are filtered, then they will be grouped, and then group functions will be applied. Okay. Let me, you know, write the flow so that it is clear. So let me write, you know, it is very important to understand this. You know, first place what is running, your where clause is running. Second, what is, you know, group group by is running, and you know, in the third position, what is running? The group functions are being run. Okay, group functions. So here, what is exactly happening? This is happening. So here you have used a where clause. You have used a where clause, so it will filter rows, and it will only filter rows where department ID is either equal to what? Either equal to 10 or either it is equal to what? It is equal to 20. So these many number of rows will be what? They will be filtered. Okay, all these rows will be filtered. So these rows are filtered. Now these rows have been filtered. Now what will happen is that now the grouping of these rows will happen according to what? According to department ID. Why? Because I have written group by what? I have written group by department ID. That is why grouping of rows will be performed with by their department IDs. So taking their respective department IDs, there are only two distinct department IDs. One is the department ID 10 and the other is the department ID what? 20. So two groups will be formed in this case. Why? Because these rows have been, you know, these rows have not been selected because they have been filtered out. They have, you know, they have not been selected. They have been filtered out by the where clause. Only where clause is first selecting the, you know, all the employees who are in department number 10 or 20, and then grouping of those rows have been performed. And then once the grouping has been performed, the group functions are being applied. Is it clear? I think it should be clear. This is very important. So if you are able to get it, then I want you to write this query. Query to find the average salary of managers, developers, analysts. See, in my employees table, if you go to the employees table, these are all distinct designations: managers, trainers, HR head, analyst, developer, technician, developers. All these are different designations, but I only want what? I only want the average salary of managers, developers, and analysts. Okay, write a query for this. Write on your own. Okay. If you have been able to do it, it is very good. If you're not able to do it, then just see what I do. Okay. So what I have to select designation, comma, I want the average salary. So which group function will I use? Average. And average of what? Average of salary. From which table? From the employees table. And then if I write group by designation, if I group by designation, then you are getting everything. But according to my query, I only want managers, developers, and what? Analysts. So what query will I write? I will write something like this. From which table? From the employees table. And then I will write where, you know, designation in what? Designation in, first one is your manager. The second one is developer. And the third one is what? It is analyst. Analyst. Okay, and then if I group by what? Group by designation. If I write it, then you will only get the average salary of analysts, developers, and managers. I think it should be clear. And here also, what will be the order of execution? The order of execution will be like this. First the where clause will be executed, then group by, and then finally group functions will be applied. So how it is happening, if you observe, I write this. Okay, select star from employees, order by designation. If, you know, I have ordered them by designation. So now if you observe, if you write again, I know, because I think it is, you know, I take this time because, you know, I just want to explain these concepts to you. So, you know, some may find it to be very long explanation, but this is the way I do it. So the things are clear. So first of all, what is going to happen? The where clause is going to run. And what does where clause do? It does filtering of rows. Select statement works row by row, and where clause will perform filtering of rows. So which rows will be filtered? This row will be filtered. Why? Because its designation is manager. This row will also be filtered. Why? Because its designation is developer. But this, sorry, yeah, these two rows will be filtered because their designation is analyst. These two rows will also be filtered because their designation is developer. And this Rashmita, will it be filtered? No, because its designation, it's what? HR head. Now again, 1 and 2, these rows will be filtered because designation is manager. And then, you know, 10, 9 and 6, will these rows be filtered? No, they will not be filtered. Why? Because their designation is not either in manager, developer, analyst. Okay, now what so we have where clause has finished its execution, it has finished perform the filtering of rows. Now what is the second thing that is gonna happen? The second thing that is gonna happen is, you know, grouping. So group by what? You have written group by designation. So according to the designation, one group will be the group of managers. One group will be the group of what? One group will be the group of developers, and one group will be the group of what? Will be the group of analyst. And then now grouping has also been performed, and once the grouping has been performed, what is going to run? The group functions will run. And what is the group functions over here that I've used over here? The group function is the AVG function. So average of salary of every group. For example, there are two analysts, and if you see, there are two analysts over here. There one is salary is 60,000, the other salary is 30,000. The sum is 90,000 and divided by 2, it is 45,000. That is why, you know, average salary of analyst is 45,000. For managers, if you go, one salary is 1,20,000, other salary is 80,000, and, you know, sum is 2 lakhs. So the average salary will be what? It will come out to be 1 lakh. Okay. Now on these groups, the group functions are running. So in this way, you are getting this output. So now I think you must be clear with what I have written over here. I have written first the where, then I have written the group by, and then I have written the, you know, this group by, and then in the third position, the group functions are gonna run. So you keep this thing in mind when you design SQL queries. All right. So I think it is clear. Now, if you go to my PowerPoint presentation and what I have written in the third point, group functions can never be written inside where clause. What does this mean? What all I have told you till now, if I am going to write group function inside where clause, what is going to happen? Let us try to see with the help of one example. For example, suppose I say I want the count of, again, the same query. I want the count of every employee in each department according to their department. So I will use the, you know, I will use the department ID, and then I will use the count because I want the count. I will use the count group functions from the employees table, and then group by what? Department ID. Here you are getting like this. Now I only want, for example, my query is that I only want those departments where the number of employees working is greater than 2. Here, this is the query. Query to display only those departments where the number of employees working is more than 2. So can I write something like this? So you first of all try this query on your own. And can, for solving it, can I write something like this? Can I write something like this? Suppose I say select, and then from employees table, and then I write the where clause, and inside the where clause I write where count star is greater than what? Is greater than 2. And then I write group by clause. Group by what? Department ID. Okay, you see, invalid use of group function. This query will never run. Why this query will never run? This will never run because of the second point which I have mentioned, that group functions are group functions can never be written inside where clause. Why do you think that I can never write group function inside where clause? What is the exact reason for it? See, I have already told you, if you just observe the order of execution, first the where clause is running, then grouping is being performed, then the group by function is being run, and then, you know, the group functions are running. So when the where clause is running, when the where clause is performed filtering of rows, is there any, you know, is, have we calculated any of the group functions? Have any of the group functions being executed? No. That is why always keep this thing in your mind, that you can never use group function inside where clause. Why you can never use it? Because once the where clause run, the group functions, the grouping has not been yet performed, and group functions have also not been, you know, calculated. So how can you use group functions inside a where clause? For so that purpose, we will be using separate clause, that is a having clause. So we will study it, you know, little later, maybe in this or maybe in the next video, we'll study the having clause for solving this problem. But for now, you just keep this thing in mind, that you can never use group functions inside where clause. Okay, now let us move on to the third point. And what is the third point? the fourth point. Only the columns mentioned in the group by clause can be selected using the select clause. So I am, you know, there is, you know, MySQL, this the fourth point which I mentioned over here, you know, it is not true in the case of MySQL, But for most of the other relational database, for example, Oracle, SQL Server, and very popular, you know, standard databases, this point is always valid. But for MySQL, it is not, you know, although you can never do it, it doesn't make sense to do it, but still, you know, MySQL allows this, and it allows you to do it. Why? Because it makes this assumption that the end user is clear of what point of query he's writing. And I also, you know, maybe in some, you know, some later versions of MySQL, this is valid. Okay, so let us see what this point is exactly saying. Let us try to understand this. So I'll, you know, just if I just, you know, write this query, select department ID, comma, count star from employees, group by department ID. So, you know, this is very simple. This is very simple. This we already seen. Okay, group by department ID. I think you are getting, you know, this. But now let me do something different. What I will do, suppose I will select the department ID, and I will select salary also. Salary comma count star from which table? From the employees table. And I say group by department ID. If I write this query, do you think that this, is there any problem? Is there any issue with this? There is a serious problem with this query, if you can make it out. First of all, let me tell the, in MySQL, you know, this query will run. It will not give any errors. But for most of the other relational database, this query will not work. I will just try to show you how it is not working with some other very popular databases. But first of all, just see that it is working in case of MySQL. And now if I write select star, okay, from employees, and then I write order by department ID, okay, to make, you know, things clear. I'll just, okay, now I'll just minimize it. Now if you see, you know, these three groups have been formed. This we already saw, you know. Okay, and I'll need to take the pen tool over here. So this we have already seen, you know. Okay, pen tool. Okay, so how many groups will be formed? I think it is very simple to answer it. These groups will be formed. Okay, this group of department number 10, then group of department number 20, and then the other group of department number 30, because I have used group by department ID. Now what I am selecting department ID, and I am selecting count, you know, it is giving the count of, you know, in number of employees in every department, but I am selecting salary also. Okay, so salary also. For example, you consider this group. If I select department ID for this group only, if I select department ID, then for every employee belonging to this group, the department ID will always be 20. But if I select salary, then whose salary? Because if you see in department number 20, you know, there are 6 employees which are working in department number 20. And if I am talking of salary, then whose salary I want to select? I have not specified it. That is why this query is never valid. Okay, that is why this query is never valid. You can always select department ID because you have group by department ID. So all the members in that group will have the same department ID. That is why you can select department ID, but you can never select salary. But in MySQL, you know, what is happening is, you know, it is giving one salary of, you know, for example, it is giving salary in department number 10, it is giving salary of Nikhil, and for department number 20, it is giving salary of, say, you know, Sonali. Okay, that is, you know, mainly it is taking, giving, you know, selecting the rows on the basis of how it has stored it. But this query is now, you know, it is not valid, and it will not work in most of the popular databases. If you try to run it on some other database, let us try to see what is the problem. Okay, I'll just take this and I think I'll minimize it. Okay, yeah. So what I've done is that this is my Oracle Live SQL. Yeah, all right. So what I've done, you just observe that I'll just minimize it. And now this is your Oracle database. This is my friends, keep in mind that this is not my SQL database. This is Oracle database. And I have created a table, that is employees table. I have not, you know, added all the columns. I have added only, you know, 4 columns, and I have inserted some dummy data inside this table. And if you do select star from employees, select star from employees, then I'll get this. Okay. You know, I'm getting four employees, Nikhil, Nitin, Neha, and Nidhi. These are the 4 employees. And now if I do something like this, what do I do? I do select department ID, comma, salary, comma, say suppose count star. From which table? From the, here also the name of the table is employees, and then I write group by department ID. If I'm gonna run this query on Oracle database, not on MySQL, my dear friends, just keep in mind, this is Oracle Live SQL. If I run it, then what will you get? You know, not a group by expression. This will query will not work. Why this query will not work? Because of this reason. Okay, if I, you know, if you go to this presentation, then what I've written, only the columns mentioned in the group by clause can be selected using the select clause. So here, if you observe, this salary, is this salary, this column which I have selected in the select clause, is it mentioned in the group by clause? No, it is not mentioned. That is why it can never be selected. But this can always be done. For example, if I write something like this, group by salary, and not to make you confused, if I don't select this salary, then this query is always gonna run. Then this query is always going to run. For example, okay. Yeah, it is going to run by in department number 20, there are two employees, in department number 10, there are two employees. But if I write, you know, you select salary and then you group by what? Then you group by salary only, okay? You group by salary only. Then it is possible to select salary, okay? You will get, okay. You are getting, you know, for, you know, one employee is getting 12,000, one employee is getting 10,000, you know, and, you know, one employee is getting 80,000, one employee is getting 120,000. But it is not possible to do something like this. Suppose I select department ID also over here. Will this query run? This query will not run. Why? Because in the group by clause, I have only used salary. That, so in the select clause also, you can only select clause. You can only select what salary. You cannot select what? You cannot select department ID. So here, if I write this and you just see it, it is not going to work. But again, this thing can also be done. Suppose I write department ID. Okay. Now I have in my group by clause, which two columns are being, according to which two columns grouping is being performed, it is being performed by salary and department. So each group will have, you know, the same salary and the same department. That is why you will be able to select what? The salary and the department ID using this query, and this query will run fine. Okay, this query will run fine. So this is what exactly I have written over here. If you observe, so this, I know this was, you know, I just showed you in, you know, other database, that is, you know, your Oracle database. So the only columns mentioned in the group by clause can be selected using the select clause. So this is not true in case of MySQL, but it is true in case in most of the other relational databases like Oracle or MySQL or any of the other relational database. Okay. So I will just end this video over here, and thank you so much for watching all the videos, and please do keep on liking and subscribing all the videos. And the next video we will study about the having clause. Okay. Thank you so much for watching my videos.